In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of adductor magnus. This is very, very big adductor muscle, okay? Adductor magnus. I'm going to explain its origin, insertion, and function. Let's talk about origin first. Origin is on pelvis, especially around pubis and ischium. So this part is about pubic ramus. Pubic ramus. And the ramus around ischial tuberosity. So it is ischial ramus. And ischial tuberosity. Three parts. Basically, it's right here around ischium and pubis. This is origin. Pubic ramus, ischial ramus, and ischial tuberosity. Let's talk about insertion. It is two parts. Basically, it's on the shaft of femur and right here. This part is on posterior part. This is linea aspera. Linea aspera. I'm going to show you posterior part later, okay? Linea aspera. And this part is adductor tubercle. Adductor tubercle. This is close to knee joint, okay? So insertion is linea aspera, which is on posterior part, and adductor tubercle. I'm going to show you from posterior view so you can see insertion very clearly. This is posterior view. Do you remember insertion? This is linea aspera and this is adductor tubercle. Origin was on pubis and ischium. This is very, very wide muscle. So let me talk about function of adductor magnus. As name of this muscle represents, main function is of course adduction. Adduction of hip joint, that is movement of this way. Okay, this is very, very, very strong hip adductor. By the way, adductor magnus can do so many other movements. Let me talk about that. So adductor magnus can do flexion and extension and flexion and extension depends on fiber, okay? From anterior part of pubis, that fiber does flexion. You know, from more on posterior part, that can do extension, okay? Function is different, depends on location of fiber, okay? And there are two more movements that adductor magnus can do. That is internal rotation and external rotation. However, this depends on article. Many articles say different thing, internal rotation. Other researchers might say adductor magnus does external rotation. It depends on article. So if you are interested in function of adductor magnus, please look this up. There are many various researches revealing internal rotation or external rotation. However, if I explain this muscle very simply, main function is, of course, adduction. Very, very strong adductor. Then in addition to adduction, adductor magnus can do flexion and extension. Depends on location of fiber and internal rotation or external rotation. This muscle is very unique muscle. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of adductor magnus, its origin, insertion, and function. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.